Hello my people, now welcome back again to my channel. Now good morning, good afternoon and good evening. For today's video, I go to tell una about the Olu of Wori Palace waiting people they go do for there, you know, so kind things. If somebody asks you today now, I beg, apart from say now the palace of the Olu waiting that they do for there again, what do you go fit tell person about them? I go tell una another thing about the kingdom when the Olu they rule over. Okay, so make una listen as I start them. I go tell una also Wori as a port city. E good make you know all these things as it be say you dey stay Wori so that you go still know some kind things when they happen inside. So Wori as a port city, due to the kingdom being surrounded by water, Wori became an important port city during the 19th century. A port town like this one would only mean one thing: becoming a hotbed for product trading. These products include cocoa, rubber, skins, palm oil, granules, palm products, and hides. During the early years of 20th century, Wori gained the British as a supporter when Great Britain made the kingdom their provincial capital. During this time, the population of the kingdom experienced a growth spurt, transforming the rural area to an urban area. Let me tell you about the Olu of Wori Palace now. Aside from the home of the king, the Olu of Wori Palace also served as the Olu's head office. Even though the palace has been around for more than 500 years, the air of elegance that surrounds it remains up to this day. Every Olu that lived in the palace made adjustments to the palace that would suit their needs. That way, the palace shows a modern and sophisticated look while still keeping its traditional aura. The Olu of Wori Palace also serve as the following. 1. Sightseeing. Yes, I know many people don't know. People from around the world visit the palace because of its elegance and beauty. Not only that, but they also want to know more about the traditions and culture of the Ishekiri people. Knowing the history behind the palace construction and the kingdom as a whole would also be in the visitors' bucket list as well. Since the palace has lots of inaccessible areas, the visitors check out the site with tour guides. 2. The appointment of traditional chiefs. Only the Olu of Wori holds power to appoint the chiefs that would serve the kingdom. These appointments attract many visitors to the area because this has become a yearly event. Just like the last coronation, you can see a lot of people, they came just to witness the occasion. So that is how it is. Number 3, the resolution of disputes. Like other locations, disputes and issues also happen in Wori. If these issues could not be resolved by the chiefs, they bring it to the palace so that the Olu himself would preside over it. Whatever the Olu decides on would be the final and irreversible. His decision will serve as the resolution for the dispute. Let me tell you guys another one. Though it is not like a final decision, the Olu also give counsel, just like the one I talked about in my last video yesterday. You can check that video, okay? So you see the issue surrounding the zoning, governorship of election, who would be the next governor of Delta States, okay? You can see that these people, they went to the Olu Palace because they need counsel from him. They need prayers from him in order for them not to still make the wrong decision. So also, this is another example. So number 4, We have the Awa Akere Festival. It's a yearly event that happens within the Olu of Warri Palace. The Awa Akere Festival aims to bring together all the descendants of the Ishekiri. It is known to be the biggest festival in the Ishekiri nation. The Awa Akere Festival started almost at the same time as the founding of the kingdom. The Ishekiri people celebrate this festival through masquerade, dancing, eating, drinking, and other fun activities, including performances done by the Ishekiri children. The festival also came to be known as the Okere Juju Festival. I know say most of una, for me, I don't know as Awa Akere Festival because I did before, when I did worry, when we still they grow up small, we still the Okere Juju, now we know how to be. So now, when I did make research now, I know say now the name be that, you understand? So now Okere Juju, now many people know how to be, even if you ask. Maybe now the indigenous they know as Okere Festival, okay? Since this happened in the Okere area, so they call it Okere Juju Festival. Besides, there is no specific date for the start of the festival. It typically starts between June and August. I don't really know when it is done again. So if you know, please drop it in the comment section, okay? Because I know there are some people, even living in diaspora, some they want to attend, you know? So at times they usually ask their friends, when is Okere Juju? Yeah. So make una still let them know when the festival they start, so that they go still understand the timing, okay? So the main theme of the festival centers on fertility, and the Ishekiri people believe that celebrating the festival will bring continuous prosperity for the kingdom. The festival officially starts in the middle of the rainy season because the Ishekiri people believe in a deity named Okioro, who they reverend as a god of water. After the festival, the Ishekiri people also go to the palace to pay homage to their Olu. So now, who is the king of Warri? Okay, maybe Ona not bite me. So a lot of people they here. You know, say as I tell Ona before, Warri na many tribes night day. Okay, so before the name of Warri, they used to call it Olu of Ishekiri. So I beg, make you understand as I dey read down, because many people now they start to talk, say why they talk like that. I know what here they talk. We self when we did that side, we know. So who is the king of Warri? The present Olu of Warri is Ogiame Atuwase III, formerly known as Omoba Shola Emiko. He succeeded the throne in August 21st, 2021. He succeeded his uncle, Ekenwole Godfrey Emiko. He is the son of a former Olu, okay? The former Olu Atuwase II, Godwin Orisheju Emiko, who started his reign from 2nd of May 1987 to 5th of September 2015. So, if you get anything when you want output, if you see output, we don't already know. Now, this question. Which kingdom is ruled by the Olu? The Olu rules over Warri Kingdom, located in Delta State, Nigeria. The kingdom has been in existence since 1480 and continues up to this day. And my last question, what is Warri known for? Oh yeah, Warri not the carry last. Mona come. Another hear this question now. Warri not the carry last. We need a green. Aside from being a major hub of petroleum-based businesses in Nigeria, Warri also became popular because of its usage of Pidgin English. It also became a port city that serves as a meeting point for traders around the world, a center of employment. So, anything you feel add, my people, na feel add, this one are my own when I bring come, okay? So, I beg, if you get anyone you want add, put, you feel the add, put now. If you add, worry, no, the carry last, we need a grill. So, I go see you now for another video. Mona, not forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye.